What it do, homies? It's your boy Dave, and I'm back today. We back here with some more Kevin. This time we're checking out his Stay With Me, Sam Smith, looping KO over. Okay, now I've only seen his looping experience one, and that's with the song Down, I believe. Guys, it's one thing to be super talented at playing instruments and singing and doing that. It's another thing to do it all at once. And that's why I really, really like looping, because everything needs to be executed, right? It's not like you only get one shot. It's just that you have to start the whole thing over if you mess up even the tiniest a bit. So that right there is already difficult. Now, I am a huge fan of Sam Smith. I believe it happened when I heard his Writings on the Wall song. I remember watching the James Bond movie, and I watched it in theaters, and it was the opening song. I can't remember what James Bond movie it was, but I'm telling you, I got enveloped with fears hearing that in a surround. I mean, it just came over me, right? Like I got baptized or something. I was like, yo, I know who Sam Smith is, but what is this performance? So Stay With Me is another one of my favorites. I know Kevin's about to absolutely kill this. Let's go ahead and shut up and turn it up. Oh yeah, here we go. Oh. Trying to find out who's on the piano. Jason, okay. Okay, hold on. See, already, right? So correct me if I'm wrong, but whenever you're orchestrating or you're composing and everything, of course, there are chords in music, and the more space in between each individual note, right, the more, you know, range that you can have. But I believe that's called voicings, right? So when you apply a lot of voicings, you can really kind of get this full spectrum of audio, just pleasing everything. And I love how he just started with that. And not only that, but the slow attack right before the release, that right, it's these small little details, the smallest details, that really kind of push forward with that emotion. And when we think about this song, it is emotional. It's very emotional. So you got to represent all that emotion and that pain and that sadness that we hear in Sam Smith's voice in the instrument. And that's what makes the cello a really, really good instrument, because it's one of the ones, and I'm gonna die on this hill, one of the instruments that is closest to the human voice. The staccato. This man, okay, look, that again, it's not even that the drum pattern is complex. It's not even that, bro. It's just the fact that when you are beatboxing, that when you start throwing in those offbeats, that things can get really messy very, very quickly, right? And you got, see, that's another thing. Notice whenever people are looping, right? You can kind of tell the confidence level based on how much hesitation goes in before they start looping another sound in, right? Some people will probably wait like an additional 4 measures or additional 8 measures to kind of get a good sense of the tempo. But Kevin just goes right into it, right? This is a person who has mastered, he's mastered tempo. You know what I mean? He's mastered complex rhythms. And he even threw in a riser because why not? Okay, very interesting. He didn't decide, and we still got some more of this to go, but you know, the part where it goes, it looks like I for a minute, I thought maybe we was going to get a whole lot of voicings, a whole lot of kind of layers and everything of instrumentation to kind of do that. But instead, right, it looks like he's done passed it over to the piano. I thought that was a really, you know, it's a really, really powerful part of the song, right? But there is a part in there where it starts at the forefront, right? But then it immediately takes a back door once Sam starts acapelling, but once he starts singing over it, right? And then that becomes the most important part. So the note that he played right before he ended, that ding, right? It was so loud and right into your face to kind of give you that sense of a transition, because you sit here and when I'm looking at musicians and they play and everything, the constant thing that's always going in my head is why did they do that, right? Why didn't they do something else? And oftentimes when I'm asking myself in my head these questions, I start thinking about things that they could have done and why they didn't do it, as to try to get a more better sense as to what's going on in a musician's head. So that, and now it looks like it's being passed over to Jason on the piano. So I bet Kevin's about to come in here and start giving us a little bit of those oh-ohs that Sam gives us. Singing it. I was gonna go hide there. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. There's nothing else you can say. It's just beautiful. Okay. I know a bunch of you guys probably down there in the comments are kind of saying to yourself, well, Dave, if you just shut up, then you would have seen that he actually was going to include that part. And I say to you, well said. Sometimes my emotions get the best of me, right? And I just want to talk about what's in my head before I lose the thought. You know what I mean? So And you know, it's almost like Kevin has become such a triple double quadruple type of threat that you almost kind of forget kind of the talents that the man possesses, right? I was sitting there thinking, all right, what's he going to do? Is the piano is going to come in there? No, piano was just the backing, right? Not just the backing. He has to reduce it. He was carrying, you know, the rhythm and everything so that Kevin could do his own thing. And I totally forgot Kevin could sing. So he's just going to sing it in there because why not? Man, I'm absolutely loving these K-overs. That's the end of this video. If you enjoyed the content, leave a like and subscribe. Dave's out.